Yes.
I'm just interested to know that when you yourself discovered the awareness and how it changed your outlook as a person to daily life.
In daily life, how it changes you? Well, it could possibly not change you at all, other than having more of a fullness of insight. You see? A clarity and of certainty, a sense of security and confidence, the presence of compassion, love, freedom, peace. But these qualities that now that you're able to recognize as being natural to your being, you now are able to bring these into full manifestation, full expression and manifestation into your life and affairs and relationships. So over and all, it would make what your friends or people around you might consider a better person. Okay, and maybe you would consider that too. Okay. It could very well happen to some people that it would occur in a spontaneous moment that awakening happens, and maybe the people around them may not even notice that it has happened, but they will know that there's a difference because the perspective from which they see things is not so much from the body-mind or the waking state per se, but rather is from the awareness that is present prior to the body and prior to the mind. And so that presence of pure awareness will be what one is living and expressing, and this efficiency and effectiveness of being will be known to oneself, but may not necessarily be that noticeable by the people around. It could be, and might be, in the sense of perhaps more efficiency, more alertness, more presence, more, you know, in that regard, but it might very well happen that there's nothing really unusual that has happened when the awakening is occurring and is complete. In other words, you're not necessarily mystical or far out or far off. You're just very, very ordinary. You might say, I'm kind of ordinary. Well, I live in the awareness of being. Now, maybe people don't think I'm so ordinary.
I wouldn't say ordinary. Not an adjective for you. Wouldn't you also say that your experience is the cessation of thoughts and the experience of the moment present, without the mind moving into the past and the future, and that one's responses to the moment are appropriate?
Yes. Yes, all of that. Free of random thoughts going on in the mind when you're quiet. No worries, no concerns, no fears. Also, no desires, for there is a quality of fulfillment, completion. That doesn't mean that you're not capable of functioning and producing and creating if something comes up, or if you are involved with someone in some endeavor. Your creativity can be enhanced, but it doesn't mean there's a compulsiveness about it. You're free. Yes.
Do you offer any guidance to ensure that we are really perceiving the I properly.
Yes. Yes, we do. In our teaching, in fact, we're the only one in the country, in the world, that does in this teaching. Your name is Paul, is it not? Well, he was mentioning it being at Ganeshan yesterday. Ganeshan is a very dear friend and is the grand nephew of Bhagavan Ramana. And Ganeshan, who used to be for 35 years was the manager of Ramana Ashram, and for 25 of those years was the managing editor of the magazine, Mountain Path, that is published by the ashram. Well, of all people who knows about Bhagavan and his teaching, Ganeshan knows where in the world there are centers of influence of people who are really involved in Bhagavan's teaching, where they are and pretty much what they are into, what they offer and what they present. And he readily states, we are the only institution in the world that presents Sri Bhagavan's teaching in its purity. And not only that, we do stay with a new student for a minimum of 6 weeks immediately after one of our programs, our entry-level teaching, where you learn the intensive self-inquiry training. And then there's, in our curriculum, we have 4 or 5 programs, and like after each one of them, you have a home study portion that goes with it, so that you have a graduate, an advanced graduate who's with you. We call them a buddy, your buddy, that it stays with you during that period of time. And then, after that, if you're really interested in taking the teaching all the way through to absolute and radical completion, realization, then we have what we call a sponsorship program that is involved within our teaching. This is just all by selection, by choice, if you wish, and you can have a sponsor. And a sponsor will be assigned to you and be with you for the rest of your life, if need be, to make sure that you are remaining. And then together, you're like a buddy or team, and you kind of support one another in making sure you're continuing to abide by and live the teaching. So we have support all the way from the beginning all the way to completion. And we're the only one who does. Okay?